And having seen this prisoner running away, the Yamas draw arrow and a shot on the donkey. This made worn on donkey's behind. So the worn automatically transformed, instead of just trying to slow down the donkey worn, they transformed it automatically. The wound transformed automatically in the form of eyes. It becomes eyes so that the vehicle of Mahakali could watch any kind of obstacles coming from anywhere. So in other words, the fear of a predictive, in other words, the authority of the time, the compulsory quality of the time and the evidence, and the regular, expected quality of a regular occurrence, like such as like day and night and years and months and so on, all these regular happenings have been upset by this energy force. And this energy has been escaped from this regular command, regular kingdom of this particular jurisdiction of the universal cosmic force. And therefore it is quite automatically these kind of energies are of Mahakali is very powerful, and in many cases that, as it said in this one of the songs of Drasimo, it says that she manifests herself as destructive quality, as a romantic inspiration, as well as inspiring inspiration and all sorts of things. All these kind of processes are very interesting. So therefore, this is the basic principle of Dakinis. And literal meaning of Dakini in the Tibetan word Kando, which literally means sky goddess. And this meaning sky, in this case, is represented in permeated by air, which is energy. Those who travel with the energy moves with the pattern of energy. And that seems to be one of the important things to realize. I think it will help to understand this basic feminine principle of the energy, which you will also extend as far as the principle of Prajna Paramita. From Prajna Paramita level up to dualistic emotions and romantic emotions. So this covers a great deal of space of the perfect emptiness, a voidness of shunyata, which is being also a pervading force, as well as the petty occurrence of destructive quality in the world, is also connected with this Dakini force. And this particular story that when Milarepa was meditating in the cave for a long time, having received many guests and teaching them, all these disciples, instructed meditation. Which is a kind of secondary journey in his spiritual development. Having completed the realization of a guru within himself, and then after that he met with his sister, as well as his supporter who brought food and helped him, hunters who were collecting feathers for the arrows, and he taught them also a great deal. And that was kind of resting period where he managed to communicate to his guru, as his inner guru, as well as this Indian demon thing that we taught this morning. And there was a kind of period of communication with human people. And then, after a certain point, still there's several layers of breakthrough had to be made. And this is the next breakthrough, is dealing with the feminine principle. And this name of Taksimo means the vampire of the rocks. Dark means rock, and simul means vampire. And he saw this very significantly crack in the wall, which is a kind of interesting thing, sort of unknown space, this, that crack that hasn't been checked and surveyed, secured. There could be spiders, or there could be moths, or there could be mosquitoes, or there could be anything that crack. It's kind of outside of the territory of the familiar scene. And from this crack, then appears the Trasimo in the red form of a red person, all colored in red skin, riding on a black deer, guided by a pretty girl. And they said that the man has disappeared immediately, having appeared and gave nod to Milarepa, big nod, and disappeared into wind, into whoopo. And then the girl transformed into a red bitch and holds on Milarepa's left toe. And in this case, the symbolism of a dog is very much connected with the feminine principle of pettiness, because when you have a house dog, that the reason why you keep a dog is trying to also use his kind of pet. He's a kind of that you could nurse, that you could regard as kind of in many cases, in housewives may be used as kind of if the wife is aware that the dog is, keeps company to the husband, that kind of companionship of secondary companion of wife, as well as dog guards against from any stranger intruders, which also means that the dog has been particularly trained and brought up to develop this kind of jealousy of not letting anyone else into your own family member. So this represents this kind of dog represents the jealousy, which is very fierce, as well as a sort of companionship of the expression of the attachment, possessiveness of it. And it is also interesting that later on in the book, that is, there is a description of Rei Chungpa when he was begging for food in a particular town, that his toe has been also bit by red bitch. And he had an accident and he had to rest. And on the process of resting, then he's been received by this young lady who belonged to a noble family. And young lady became his lover. And he kept Rei Chungpa for several months in their house, in which Milarepa had to go and rescue him in disguise as a beggar. And it seems this principle of a bitch plays quite an important part. Which quite rightly holds the left toe, the left aspect of the body, left side is associated with the feminine principle, right associated with the masculine principle. The passive being the feminine and the active being the masculine.